Jamal, nice to see you. How's life being a Swansea City player for the second time?
It's good. It's good to be back, honestly. Really, really happy to be back. Looking forward to getting more minutes, more fitness levels, and hopefully bring some goals and some wins to the camp.
Imagine a player with your record, proven goal scorer in the Championship. You probably had a few options, did you, when you were available on deadline day?
Yeah, there's a few clubs throughout the window, but nothing of serious interest in my case. But when Swansea come about, that was one that I really jumped on and pushed back for it to happen, really. So I'm glad that it got done in the end.
Why was that? Presumably because you enjoyed your first spell at the club.
Really enjoyed it. Enjoy living in Swansea as well. The first time I left, it was kind of out of my hands. That wasn't really in the plans for me to leave. I was really enjoying my football, but such as the game that we play, sometimes it's out of your hands a little bit, and to come back was definitely something that was in the back of my mind, and when it came about, then for sure I was ready for it.
Yeah, okay. Was it a change of manager, basically, in short?
Pretty much, yeah. Pretty much change of manager. Obviously, we had a very near miss in promotion. Change of manager, change in style, change in ideas, and change in personnel as well. I think a lot of players come in, a lot of players come out. Players didn't get new contracts that were here, so it's part and parcel of the game, really.
I think I'm right in saying your contract at Bournemouth up next summer. Is that right?
Yeah, that's correct. Yeah,
and you're on loan. Initially, there was talk of loan till January. In the end, you signed on loan for the season.
Yeah.
So, how do you look at it? Is it too early to say, or are you thinking I want to be here for longer than a season?
For me, yeah, I'd love to be here for longer than just a season. But again, that's a little bit out of my hands as well. I guess that's all performance based. So I'll be trying my best to make sure that they want to keep me for longer than just a year.
What about your fitness and conditioning, Jamal? You're just getting up to speed still?
Getting up to speed, yeah. It's been a tough pre-season for me. I didn't play any pre-season games. Which is hard, but I feel like I'm slowly getting there. And the best way to do it is to play games, like playing in a reserve game or in training or doing extra running. It gets you to a certain level, but there's nothing like being on the pitch. And hopefully, it won't take much longer, and I'll be fully fit and firing. So,
Sheffield Wednesday this weekend, another team who are down the bottom end of the early season table.
Yeah,
it's a big game, isn't it? Would you say?
I mean, every game is a big game. Obviously, we're only a couple games in, so the table looks what it looks like right now, but that can quickly change. I think we're performing a lot better than we was at the start. And I feel it was obviously unlucky the other night. They scored in the 94th or 95th minute, whatever it was. So I feel like there's positivity in the group. Like, we all feel very confident that the results will come if we perform the way we need to and run as hard as we need to and commit to the plan and commit to our style of play, I think we'll be all right.
Do you think the league position then doesn't reflect the quality that's in the squad?
Yeah, the league position is very false. Like, you could be at the top of the league, and whoever's at the top of the league now may not be there come May. Do you know what I mean? There's obviously there's obviously Leicester, who are probably the favourites, but Ipswich might not be there towards the end. Preston probably won't be there. Do you know what I mean? It's very early on. A few wins, they could go a few games without a win, and then we've go 3-4 on the bounce, and all of a sudden it looks completely different. So I wouldn't say it's anything to stress about at this stage of the season, but we're working as hard as we can to make it look a lot nicer for the fans.
What's the key, do you think, then, to trying to get that first result this weekend?
I think it's patience and confidence and just sticking together, really. Obviously, we went 1-0 up the other night quite early on in the game, and then towards the end of the game, it was like we hung on to it a little bit, whereas if we just played the same way we did in the first half, we could have got 2 or 3. So it's just that confidence and the ability to not get fazed at whatever stage of the game we're in, if we're under the cosh for a little bit. So it's just that, and I feel once that comes, the confidence will grow even more, and you'll see more from every player.
And you must be looking forward to playing at what is now the Swansea.com stadium with fans there.
Yeah.
Didn't happen
I think it happened once. I think it was literally the playoff semi-final was the only time, and that wasn't full capacity, was only, if I remember. It was 2,000 or something.
Yeah, 3,000.
Yeah, so that was like the first time, obviously, playing at home with fans. First time my kids ever went to the stadium. Like, it was just, it was really surreal, and it was the second last game to the season. So it'll be nice to play in front of a full stadium at home. Nice for the kids to come and see the stadium, to watch a game in a stadium, which they didn't really get to do last time round. So I'm excited for that.
Just need to win the game now. Just to,
that'll be the icing on the cake, man. A good performance and a win is what everyone wants. So we're working our hardest to get that.
Thanks, Jamal.
No worries.